I'm starting a small business, he wonders. What pitfalls should I avoid? Well, considering that I started my small business in 1996, and I've been, I guess, running my small business for over a decade now, I guess I have some amount of experience. Over the years, I've picked up a few tips and tricks. The bottom line, though, is nobody is going to know your business better than you. And if you want other people to understand your business, the onus is on you to make it easier to understand your business model. So these things may be swimming inside your head, but if you can't translate them, if you can't communicate them, your small business is not likely to go anywhere because you're not going to have any customers, or at least not likely to have customers who would understand exactly what it is that you're providing for them. Another thing I would keep in mind as I remember the things that I had done when I started the small business. You can take shortcuts, but you also have to know that you need to spend money. Yeah, you can't just float along for free. Yes, there are plenty of grants that you may be able to apply for, small business loans, potentially. But, you know, ultimately you have to decide what you need to get going. Can you start without necessarily taking a loan? Good. You don't need to take a loan. Can you do it without funding? Everybody I've talked to has really been surprised that I was able to make it this far without going to anybody else for any amount of funding. No VC, no angel investors, unless of course you count like $500 that my mom gave me to kind of get things going back in the beginning. It's paid off, you know, really well for me, but that was my business model. I understood my model. I understood my value proposition, what I wanted to do, and how I was going to do that. And then, of course, I was able to execute upon it. So I didn't need to get funding. I needed to spend money in terms of like web hosting, in terms of you know, certain supplies. You need to make that investment, but don't make so much of an investment that you're not able to recoup it. So do as much as you can on your own, and you know, if you can't do that, then you may need to look into external sources. You know, a bank may give you a loan, but that doesn't mean they think it's a good idea. Keep that in mind too. There are a lot of great ideas out there, and your small business may have a great idea, but it's never about the idea. It's all about the implementation. That's the bottom line. So make no mistake, people may love what you do or what you say you're going to do, but you've got to be able to do it. Another thing to keep in mind as an entrepreneur or a small business owner is that you have to yield control. Now, this is something that I've definitely struggled with over the years, but have, you know, certainly gotten better at, you know, giving responsibilities and tasking people with certain things that need to be done, and give people a chance to work for you. You can't do everything. But knowing that you can't do everything, you have to yield control. But you don't want to yield control because you're the one who understands the business model. Only you can do it right, to a certain degree. Know when it's time to hand over some of the reins. Nobody's going to protect the business like you're going to protect the business. Nobody's going to have an eye on that business like you are. But still, you're going to need help. I mean, every successful small business likely will need help at some point in the future. I wouldn't necessarily recommend turning to friends or family at that point. That's where things can get a little wacky. Yeah. Friends and family, good to keep as friends and family. Colleagues and coworkers, good to keep in the other universe. So when it comes time to hand over some of the reins to people, go through the hiring process. And if you need help, there are plenty of organizations online or offline that will provide more specific advice to you in your endeavors. It's really what I have on the top of my head, and I want to pass it along to anybody else in the community who's also started up a small business. If you have any foibles to share, some pros and cons, things that you've gone through, your own experiences, feel free to post them. Video response or a comment.